Picking up this needle with my bare hands would put me at risk for an exposure to bloodborne pathogens. This is a safer way to pick up a needle. By using this hemostat, the needle never touches my skin. This is a simple example of a proper work practice control. Work practices such as using hemostats instead of bare hands to pick up a dropped needle reduces risk of exposure. Other safe work practices include limiting the surfaces touched and practicing consistent hand hygiene. It's important to note that this is the employer's responsibility to ensure that safe work practices are used by establishing written safety procedures and by providing proper training and supervision. Self-sheathing needles, needleless systems, puncture-resistant disposal containers for contaminated sharp instruments, resuscitation bags, and ventilation devices are examples of engineering controls. The standard also requires that every employer whose employees use medical sharps in direct patient care must identify, evaluate, and select engineering and work practice controls, including safer medical devices. This must be done at least once a year. Oregon has additional rules that require employers to ask for input and advice from non-managerial employees during this process. We'll talk more about that in this module. In the next presentation, we'll review the Bloodborne Pathogen Standards requirements for using controls and practices.